at the last round, it was a tough time out for the Australian GT Championship.
Whack. Bit of contact.
Such a big impact. Now, there's just two rounds to go, and the championship fight looks like it's down to a two-horse race. So get ready, because these thoroughbreds are about to launch.
Oh, big crash. Max Twing launches over the back.
The penultimate round of the Australian GT Championship is set to go at one of Australia's most historic racetracks. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Sandown International Raceway. It's an old-school 3.1-kilometre circuit built around a horse track that this weekend will give way to a different kind of thoroughbred. We have beautiful machines ready to go for 2 one-hour races this weekend and a championship battle that is really heating up. Sfirmias have battled the Audis as Nathan Antunes has a slim points lead over German import Christopher Mies. And for more on how they stack up this weekend, let's hear from Kylie King.
It's the final hurrah on home soil for the Australian GT Championship this year, and there's a new leader at the top of the points table, Nathan Antunes. The Audi driver has been a consistent racer and would like nothing more than to consolidate his championship lead this weekend.
It'd actually be my first ever championship if I took this one out this year, so I'm very hungry for it.
Chris Mies and new teammate Ryan Millier took out the last round at Sydney Motorsport Park, but believes they'll have a challenge ahead of them at this track.
Sandown is probably the worst track for us this year with the long straights. You know, that's not the strength of the Audi. It's more like we're losing up to 10k on just on the straight compared to the Ferrari. So the goal for this weekend is just to score as many points as possible to have a strong position for the final round in New Zealand and then go all in there.
Grant Denyer has made a late charge to be third in the championship, but after racing solo at the last round, he'll again team up with Tony D'Alberto in a bid to emulate their Townsville success where they claimed the round.
Because I haven't been racing regularly, it's great to have Tony around because, you know, he's a gun V8 supercar co-driver and I learn a lot from him, so that's why the relationship, you know, is ideal. Having said that, he's a pro and we've got to stop a little longer in our regulated pit stops. So that kind of makes the weekend a little harder or a little more fun, depending which way you look at it, because you've got to pass more cars. And that's really what it's all about. It's being out there and seeing how quickly the red blur can go.
McLaren drivers will be hoping for better success after wet conditions sent them into costly spins.
Yeah, look, that was the first wet race we'd had for a long time. And I'm not a professional driver, and I think that I blame myself. But it was funny that all three McLarens did the same thing at the same place, except I found the wall. Clark did a 360, and Tony Walls, he hit the wall too, so.
A new team has entered the GT Championship. Rossstone Racing has joined the fold with experienced driver Andrew Medici behind the wheel of an Aston Martin.
I've been looking forward to the challenge of driving a GT car. The whole category appeals to me. The people in it appeal to me. The cars are equal. And it's an opportunity later on for me to do some driving with George, my son. So, you know, I'm very happy so far with what I have and what I've seen.
In the trophy class, Mark Griffith is closing in on the title, but with only two rounds remaining, he desperately needs to come up trumps in the close racing with his rivals.
After Sydney with Greg Taylor, he came up to me at the end and said, that's the best racing we've had, you know, for a long time. And it was. We banged a couple of times, but no damage, no harm, no foul, and was all good racing.
Time to check out the points here, and a different-looking leaderboard after Sydney Motorsport Park now sees the two Audis at the top. Nathan Antunes, 11 points over Christopher Mies. Grant Denyer, who's having a remarkable year, now into third position. And Tony Quinn, the big story of this round, dropping from the series lead back to fourth and has over 100 points now to claim back if he wants to win a series here in the Australian GT Championship. Again, we had another two qualifying sessions here to set the grid for race number one of the weekend, and Kiwi GT ace Jono Lester grabbed another pole position for the year. It's going to be an all-Ferrari front row as V8 Supercar co-driver Tony D'Alberto fills the front row in the 88 Ferrari for race number one. We need a break, though, but on the other side, we come back with race number two of Australia's glamour category. The Australian GT Championship gets set to go green here at Sandown.
Yeah.
It's race day here at the Wilson Security Sandown 500, and Marcus Marshall joins me for this one, a 13-turn course and a beautiful track.
Thanks, Pat. Yeah, fantastic course. Sandown Raceway, a horse racing track in the middle and a racetrack on the outside, quite unique.
It's a different kind of horsepower here at Sandown. 13 turns, 3.1 kilometres. Cars rolling out to the track for race number two of the weekend. Let's check out some highlights of race number one. Race one got underway in a setting sun here at Sandown. The two Ferraris led us away to turn number one here with this 30-car field. Turning through the first sequence of turns, Morgan Haber carved his way through the field in the 28 Mercedes, the Interlock entry there. Then this battle went on between young Elliot Barber and the 74 J-Mac Pem Audi. What about Clark Quinn? He held back a strong challenge here as he worked his way through the field, getting Barber earlier in the race too. A great drive for him and Wood yesterday in the first race. And then Mies and Millier, the 74 J-Mac Pem Audi, trying to claw their way up through the field. Nathan Antunes tried this ambitious move down at turn nine and found the gravel and ultimately cost him a podium position in race one. The Barton Moore, Mike O'Donnell Porsche collision down here at turn three. Thought we might have got a safety car here, but it kept on going as Andrew Medici unloaded the Aston Martin down here. A little front end damage to car number 95 being prepared by Ross Stone this weekend. Griffith got the edge of the curb coming out of turn number one and spun the 19 Audi, taking him on the safety cones for a lap around the course. Jan Jinnadasa, sure there was assistance down there at turn nine, but he spun car 71 as Denya come through for another win here in dominating fashion at Sandown Raceway in race one of the Australian GT Championship for this weekend. Wow, a lot can change in 15 hours since we threw the checkered flag out in this field last night. A whole range of penalties that were handed out over the course of the night. When we left here last night, the 27 Ferrari was second. It's going to start down in eighth position today. They copped a 26-second penalty for the crew guys being across the line in the pit lane before the car came in. So they've got a bit of work to do back there in eighth. But D'Alberto and Denya, very strong yesterday. Morgan Haber will start on the front row. Mies and Millier will start on the second row. Mies has now taken the championship lead. James Gunduras did a great job yesterday in fourth position. Then the likes of Tony Quinn, who got himself inside the top 10. Tony DeFelice, even though he had a spin, got himself to 11th position. Tony Walls will stand out of 12th. Then Voigt and Tebb. Michael Hovey this weekend, the Janetta starts out of 14 down to Griffith. And Taylor and Moore, who had a couple of spins also in the Adena apartment sponsored car yesterday. And some of the cars in the challenge class and trophy class entries down there. Jan Jinnadasa staying out of 29. And Twig and Emery, battery failure for those guys yesterday. Didn't even get a lap in the books. And that was the hard luck story of yesterday, wasn't it?
Yeah, he got a $400,000 car and probably a $200 batteries let him down, which is really disappointing for those guys. But they'll have good car pace. Morgan Haber was one of the quickest cars out on the circuit yesterday, the sister car there at Erebus Motorsports. So I'm sure Max and Emery will be coming through the field.
Clouds starting to break here at Sandown early on Sunday morning. Much warmer than what we had yesterday for air conditions here as the Lexus RCF safety car heads to pit lane. It's a one-hour race when the green flag comes out. 46 laps in duration. Ferrari and Mercedes on the front row. They crawl up. I love this part. They roll past us here on the start-finish line. Coming to the green flag here. And waiting for it to drop. And here it is. We're underway. Race two of the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli.
Well, that start wasn't quite right there. Morgan Haber missed that, but he's lost a spot there off the start, and I think he'd be disappointed with himself there.
This guy is going to be on a charge. Nathan Antunes today after that moment down at turn nine cost him the championship lead and probably almost cost him the win, really, didn't it, yesterday?
Yeah, look, it's that traffic thing, passing traffic. He's made a small mistake, got hard on the ABS, and he's very lucky to, well, Gunduras there almost losing it. He was very lucky to made it through the gravel trap at Dandenong and get back out.
Found himself towards seventh position at the end, but it's Denya that leads us, of course. If you started the race yesterday, you'll finish the race in today's one-hour race. They're a bit lively for the first lap here as the Leicester Smart Ferrari goes down the inside of the iMac Porsche to move up position. They'll have the angry pills in today, won't they?
Oh, yeah, they will, those guys. Is that good luck bear inside? There's not working too well for them at the moment. They're having a lot of bad luck these days. But, yeah, very fast. Fastest car yesterday, obviously pole position, and they've got the pace to do it. So,
and look at Antunes, up to fourth position already. So Daniel leads us through. Christopher Mies, who are on board with right now in the J-Mac Pem Audi, up to second position and looking for a pass down the inside. Don't recommend that from that far back.
I think this first half hour stint, you got all the pros in. It's going to be a really good battle, this. Boys are fighting hard right now for position. You know, it's still a little bit cold out there. The sun's out, but very fast conditions, fair enough. So there'll be some quick lap times turned out this morning.
The two Ferraris hit the Darrell Lee sticks. McLaren's entry also carving their way through the field on lap two. So it's a time certain finish here, not a lap duration event.
The start of the race here, Morgan Havis has completely missed the start. I think he'll be a bit disappointed in himself there.
Just explain though, with a rolling start, it's not as simple as just whacking the throttle down, is it?
No, it's not. I mean, you've got cold tyres, wheel spin, you know, you got to stay side by side with the car beside you. You can see there Morgan's back a little bit, you know, he probably really, he's missed the green flag there. Reaction time is a bit slow, so he was disappointed in himself for that.
This is heading down to turn one. That's why we're showing the replays a moment ago. So Haber, getting comfortable now with the Mercedes, gets up to second position. Fairly racy, like we said, the pro drivers, if you like, the stronger out of the two drivers are in the car right now, trying to push as hard as they can. And the lap times are showing that 109.57 for Jono Lester earlier on. We'll hand over to Graham Smythe as he goes down the inside of Haber this time at turn one, and looks like he's got the job done.
Great move.
Well, we're just getting things started here at Sandown. Come back and join us after the break for more action for the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli. It's horsepower of a different kind here as we welcome you back to Sandown Raceway for our coverage of this round of the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli. Change for the lead here at the end of lap number 10. He might have just got it done here, but I think the 88 Ferrari is going to challenge him down the main straight. This is an expensive drag race.
Oh, yeah.
Dead even at the line.
Wow.
As they come past the lap car ahead.
Great job by Grant, don't
they? And they're still side by side.
Yeah, what a battle.
Poor old Rob Smith here doesn't know what's going on behind him. He's going to hold up a 27 Ferrari, and he's still fighting on here.
Oh, Jono's sort of ended up worse. Oh, no, he's still in touch here. This is always good to see a good battle between teammates. Always a little bit of touchy subjects.
Lots of respect, though, between the two.
Yeah, great hard racing there.
So Denya holds on, and that would have been the wake-up call. Not that he needed one.
No, extremely fast today. Yesterday's fastest lap was a 109.1. Lester's just pumped out a 108.5, huge speed this morning, perfect conditions.
Andrew McPherson getting into this mix now too in the number 51 iMac Porsche on the back of Haber. Antune starting to get into this. We approach the pit stop window. It's about 12 minutes away, so they're all trying to get a bigger gap as they can. We've got some modified pit stop times from yesterday, which we'll go through as the window opens. And a lot of the teams will just be hoping they don't exceed the limit or have too many crews across the line. And
yep. Young Brad Shields, he's doing a great job here too in the IMAX 911 Porsche. He's new to the series, came in just after Clipsal. They had another driver there but at the time, but young Brad's doing a great job, pushing quite hard, and I think he's starting to reel in Morgan Haber now.
It's a good combination. Andrew McPherson, who actually owns the car for the IMAX team, will hand it over to Shields later on. He runs in fifth position at the moment with Antunes on the back. Car 6 in 6th position. The Squirk Beechwood Holmes Audi R8. Now the McLarens just starting to get into this. They were together for a while, but now separated a bit. Clark Quinn, who goes past Rob Smith.
Yeah,
car 57, the Victorian racing here this weekend. And it's back on. He's going to have a cheeky look down the inside. Thinks better of it.
Absolutely on the limit there, Jono Lester. There was nothing left of it under brakes. Here we go again with the traffic, but this is going to be like a whole race, so we have to tell whoever deals with the traffic best.
Past Indira and Patiachi in the 35 Porsche. Off goes Griffith in the Hog's Breath Cafe. Griffith Corporation entry down at turn one. This will be a replay down at one. And just lost the car well and truly before the apex of turn one.
Very easy to do down there. The bumps are very unsettling under brakes into there, and it's very easy to lose the rear of the car. Jono's got a good run on Grant here. I wouldn't be surprised if Grant's covering him. And right in the brake zone, Jono's had a little bit of a look. Down there, a good looking car, aren't they?
They're fantastic.
And sound great.
Any Ferrari looks good.
Yeah, true. Yeah, Ferrari cool. Look good in my garage at the moment.
6 seconds will be the difference between the two pit stops here. Leicester will have a 209 pit stop, a 203 for Denyer, so yeah, doing a good thing here.
That's quite a big, as Tony was saying there in his interview, yeah, that is quite a big advantage. You know, 6 seconds for these guys, they're so close to the pace. You know, no safety car or anything. Jono's looking good.
Tony DeFelice in the lane here, the vicious rumours. DeFelice Holmes entry.
It's a pity that Christopher Mees got caught up in that battle earlier. He's got the same sort of pace now as Grant and Jono. He would have been right there in that battle.
They've changed the lead while we're in the pits just then, so he's finally broken through. Jono Leicester needs to get a margin now.
Yeah, that's right. Must have got him down in Dandenong corner road, so. Grant just needs to stay in touch with him here and keep as close as he can. You never know, on the pit stop anything can go wrong. And try and push Jono into a mistake.
A replay coming up, and just a textbook move down here, wasn't it, on Dandenong Road corner. Didn't leave it too late.
Wow.
That's got in nice almost, too. Gentlemen, wasn't it?
Yeah, very nice. Very tidy.
Here's James Gandouras. He did very well yesterday. Car 47 finds himself in ninth position now, battling with Aaron Tebb, who will hand the car to Stephen Voigt when the pit stop window opens.
Two Porsches battling away there.
These are great-looking Porsches too. This is what you more see in the endurance-style races. They're different to the Carrera Cup cars, aren't they?
Yeah, that's right. And these cars are 2013 spec, so you know, they're a fair way behind in compared to what you're seeing up the front, the R8. And even the SLS and things like that. They're an older car, but still do the job.
Things are starting to heat up here at Sandown. Come back and join us for continuation of Race 2 of the Australian GT Championship. It's a beautiful day here at Sandown International Raceway as we welcome you back to Race 2 of the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli here at Sandown. In comes the 88 Ferrari, DeFelice is made a stop. That'll be his compulsory one as in comes Denyer to hand over to Tony D'Alberto.
Yeah, they're getting him in straight away. Get Tony in there and try and get out there and pumps a couple of good laps out and try and get maybe that 6 second advantage. You try and make some time up on that. Anything can happen on the way into the pits, the way out, get caught up and get slowed down. So Jono's advantage, Jono Leicester's advantage could be evaporate real quick.
So the lead has gone in, so Leicester takes it. 2 second advantage at the moment. Some of the cars running inside the top 10 include Antunes, the two Quins, Clark ahead of Tony. Aaron Tebb doing a great job this weekend in the Porsche. We saw him a moment ago.
Yeah, he's done great. It's their first race meeting this year in that car, and he looks very well prepared, and yeah, he's doing a great job.
Clock's almost stopped ticking here for the 88 Ferrari. And Tony D'Alberto will take it home to the chequered flag. Off he goes.
Tony's little warm-up before the 500 today.
He'll be a tired boy by the end of 5 o'clock this afternoon.
Yeah, he'll sleep well tonight.
Out he comes in front of Tony Walls and Morgan Haber, who's got the headlights flashing here. A common sight in GT racing. The attention of the cars ahead. Well, left it late. Walls gives him a bit of room. And now the McPherson car almost gets Shields to the back engines.
And Brad Shields there as well. Huge slide, huge moment. And that was quite a critical moment there, actually, to get past on the pit stop there on the way out in front of Tony. That'll help Nathan when he stops as well.
And the good thing is, you can come straight back up the pits and really get back into it, because the tyres sort of lost much temperature.
Yeah, that's right. You're not coming back out on cold tyres, exactly. And 9 times out of 10, they've gone through a bit of a heat cycle. What I mean is, they've been out, they're hot. We get to bleed the tyres down a little bit too, get them to their optimum temperature in pit lane before they're sent out. And 9 times out of 10, you'll come out and the car's even better again. Oh, big move by Antunes there. Up the inside of Tony Walls. Got that done. That's what he needs to do. Just push on, get those ones out of the way, and hope that Tony and other people get a bit held up by some traffic.
This is what happened the lap prior. And look how close that was.
Good save.
McPherson slides his way through and almost ran into the back. Could have been a big incident down there.
Yeah, that was very well saved, that's for sure.
So Leicester continues to lead after starting from 8th position with that penalty. He'll have to pit very soon.
Oh, the Camaro here, he just exited pit lane. I heard it roaring past our commentary box there. and just had a bit of a moment at turn one and ended up in the, out in the gravel, out in the grass.
So it's McIntyre. Let's hand it over to McMillan if he's just left the pit lane. It's in comes the leader now. At the end of lap 28, with 28 and a half minutes to go.
Clark Quinn's got his stop done as well. These, I think that was Shields in the car, and McPherson's about to get in.
Straight out and straight into the grass. We saw that a few times yesterday, and plenty of runoff on the inside there for the Camaro.
Plenty of grunt to get out of there.
And now Ryan Millier jumps aboard the JMEC PEM Audi. Christopher Mees, another solid drive there. The series leaders jumping in, and a bit of pressure now, Millier, to bring this home right now. He drove very solid at City Motorsport Park. Quick tap on the shoulder, say, I don't know how you say it in German, bring it home, brother.
Yeah, me either. I'm not going to attempt it either. Yeah, Ryan, he's got a bit of pressure on him, but he's doing a good job. He held pressure really well at Eastern Creek for that race win. Like, he'd just been thrown in there. And he did an excellent job. Tough situation and held on for the race win. It was fantastic.
So Lester out of the car. Graham Smythe jumps in, the Kiwi combination. 24-year-old from Auckland. Morgan Haber in. So they're going to change tyres on there. Interesting.
Yeah,
he's damaged
right.
The tyre there,
yeah,
maybe.
He might have, yep, that is possible. Or switching around tyres. So the working side here is generally the right-hand side of the car, so the lazy side's the left-hand side. So most guys will switch and use the left side on the right to just get the most out of the tyres, since the left side usually doesn't get much wear.
And the car feels weird. If you just change one tyre on these cars and keep the other three on, it really changes the characteristics of the car, doesn't it?
Oh, massively, yeah. They've got to be sort of like matched almost, I suppose. Clark's done well here through all that pit stop and everything. He got in front of Anchins without having to pass him on the track. So Clark needs to push on here, and he's doing a great job.
Bad news for Tony DeFelice. He's going to get a drive-through penalty, so his day continues to get even worse. Car 49. It's out comes. Number 27 Ferrari, so this will be it now. Comes out in front, and there it is. Oh, that's the gap.
There you go. There's that six seconds that the advantage that they got.
So the hard work has paid off here and now sets us up for a thrilling 25 minutes and 45 seconds of this race two, Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli. Changes through the field as we welcome you back to Sandown for round five, the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli.
Look at that, Ferrari, McLaren, Audi R8, Ferrari, awesome.
Expensive top 10, that's how we like it.
Yeah, there's still a few people to pit yet.
And some opting to leave it towards the end of the race, because if you're a pro driver, you can't do any more than 33 minutes to begin with, so.
Yeah, that's right.
Haber just waiting to complete his pit stop as Richard Gardner comes in challenge class, the safety stop Porsche. And now Haber gets released. Sweet sounding Mercedes.
Oh, yeah.
A little way it rumbles past us here.
Yeah, yeah, fantastic car, the SLS. And I can't wait to see the new AMG GT come out. It's going to be fantastic.
Even though they've got the pit lane speed limits on, they just sound so angry. They just want to be released.
Yeah, that's right. 40 k's an hour is pretty slow after you've been out there belting around at 280 kilometres an hour.
Antunes is going to give us a demonstration now of how to do 40 k's an hour down the lane. So he brings in the Squirk Beechwood Homes entry. Relinquishes the lead, but this is where it'll be from this point onwards.
Haber did quite well there. He's got good pace. And with his penalty there, he had lesser penalty than Lester. If he can keep a good pace here for the last back end of the race, he's in a good position for a podium.
23 second less pit stop for him, so it's a big gain. Of course, he's come out with a semi-cold tyre, so this is the battle for the lead that you're seeing right now, even though they're running down inside the top 10. So Haber did a great job yesterday, I thought, in 28. And then you've got the 27 Trash Family Motorsport Ferrari of Graham Smythe behind him, and then Tony D'Alberto. It's a cool looking top four.
Yeah, that's right. I think it's all about to sort itself out here with all the pit stops and look at the Ferrari on the McLaren down the back straight. Wow. Clark must have got a slightly bad run out of the onto the back straight there, but that was very impressive.
And heavy traffic ahead here. Sort of light up just the rear then on the 27 Ferrari. You can see the rubber being laid down behind.
Yeah.
what they call a pinch point, isn't it, the top there. They get it right out to that curve without touching, and it's hard in on the left-hand side.
Yeah, that's right. It's a tricky part there. You can't quite see the other side of the track when you come out over Dandenong there, but what?
So Entrance comes out, right in front of the group. So look at the lead he's got over him now. That's at least 5 seconds.
Yeah, Tony Quinn in the lead at the moment. Ryan Miller second. Tony hasn't pitted yet. And Ryan has, so he's officially the leader at the moment. Andrew McPherson, or Shields, I'm not sure if McPherson has pitted.
He's pitted, it should be Shields in the car then.
Yep. And then James Kouderis. Go, James.
I thought yesterday's race, plug. No, I thought his drive yesterday was phenomenal too. Kouderis coming through the 47 Porsche here. Sandtunes pulls the pass down, Richard Gardner.
Yeah.
We've seen ourselves up here for a thrilling finish.
Ugly on the curve there, the Lamborghini. That was almost a big tank slapper.
That's Glenn Wood now, who's changed over from Elliot Barber. He'll take us through to the end. So you approach 20 minutes remaining, lap 31. Fastest lap back on lap 9 for Jono Lester, 108.56. Most of the cars back in the 1 minute 10 second range now.
Yeah, that's right. Still quite good pace for the length of the race has gone, and the tyre wear and everything. It's very, very good pace.
So Tony Quinn leads us around the Darrell Lee Sticks. Number 7 McLaren trying to get himself back into championship contention after damaging the McLaren up there at City Motorsport Park as it's peak out down here in turn 2 and 3.
There's a lot going on there all at once. I couldn't even work it out.
Man, so many cars trying to squeeze through a really tight section of Sandown Raceway. They've got the lapped Griffiths car ahead here. Headlights flashing for Morgan Haber.
Yeah, Morgan needs to get past here real quick. Yeah, he has. And then this is going to hold up the two Ferraris over here. Even the Audi, I think, Ryan hasn't been able to get up the inside of it. And that's going to give Morgan a little break. And he's going to... that'll go a long way towards a good result. Just getting that break each time in the traffic like that and keep his head down at a good pace. And he's looking good.
It's Griffith they're trying to get past here. He's in 20th position, a lap down at the moment. While these guys battle for a top five position. And Quinn continues to pull away from Ryan Millier. Here is Quinn. He's right down at turn 1. While those guys battle, he'll just drive into the distance.
Yeah, Tony's doing a good job in this part of the race. Got a good, solid race pace. Like all the old boys out there, they know how to pull a good race pace.
And had to get right up on the curb there, otherwise both cars would have gone off the track, and they're side by side still. Down here is now the 88 Ferrari gets into it.
Wow. On the young and old here.
Well, Clark Quinn now splits them up. Grant Denyer just grits the teeth there for a split second. I think it's more than wow at the moment.
Yeah.
You say more than that inside the helmets.
It's always like that when you're not in driving. You're like, us drivers are control freaks. We always like to be the one driving. Well, big move there with Nathan Anchins on James Kouderis.
So that's change of position there for those guys. He goes up to 4th.
Yep.
Once they can clear the lap traffic, easier said than done because it's constant lap traffic at this end of the race.
Elliot Barber's done a great job of handing that car to Glenn Wood, and now they're up in 6th spot there in the Lambie. That's a good comeback from their punchy yesterday that they had.
So that's how it looks. Quinn from Millier, McPherson and Antunes, the top 4. There's 10 seconds from 1st to 4th. It's out the slipstream comes Graeme Smyth. To pass the second of J. McPhem Audis of McLaughlin.
Smyth's doing a great job in this Ferrari. He's bowled him in, and he's got good pace, and he's on the pressure end of the stick today. He's got to finish the job off. They're the pace setters, so really they're, I'm sure they'd love to get a race win over their teammate, their stable mate. They're sort of stealing all the...
Antunes, last minute, gets up another position now, so he's up to 3rd.
Oh, then this is Wood on the inside of James here.
Gee, it's busy.
Haber, yeah, there's a lot going on here. After the pit stops, everything's sort of working its way out of sorting themselves out. And Haber getting under James Kouderis there.
After the break, we'll head straight through to the checkered flag in round 5, race 2 of the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli. We'll be right back. The clock is beginning to wind down to the closing minutes as we welcome you back to Sandown Raceway. Down to turn nine they come. Tony Quinn, who's done so much in his career and just a very driven businessman, isn't he?
Tony's definitely got that worked out. He's a very successful businessman in his own right and racer too. I first started racing Tony at Lakeside in Formula Fords, and he was around all that time ago. But he's had a little huge amount of experience in all sorts of cars, and he's actually a great guy for Motorsport Australia. He's done a lot for the sport, sponsored a lot of young guys, a lot of teams, events, and VIP have always been a big supporter of that.
Look at this, and now he's starting to feel pressure from Ryan Millier.
And I can tell you, Tony's one of the hardest guys ever to pass.
Oh, you won't make it easy.
No, he's got it worked out. Oh, Ryan's got a bit of a run on him here.
Is it fair to say Ryan Millier's a rookie?
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
This is amazing.
Yeah, he's doing a great job. Side by side here with McLaren over the top. I don't know who's going to give in. Oh, Tony's led him through. Smart move. It's quite a brave area to hang on the outside over there.
So new leader now. Ryan Millier takes us down to turn nine after getting a great run out of turn three. And what can he do from here? This will be a great run. This will extend their championship lead if he can hold on to this position.
Say Millier is a rookie, but he's not a rookie at race win. He was in this position. He had the pressure on him, so it's going to be a whole lot easier, this one, for him. Black flag to Tony Quinn.
We'll get back to that in a moment. Here's a replay of what happened to the number 75. Audi being spun around down there. The news has come through. It's going to be a drive-through penalty for pit lane speeding for car 7, and also Nathan Antunes is going to get one as well.
Ouch.
Right at the wrong time of the motor race.
Yeah, Tony was driving so well too. He's in for a good position. He had a really good consistent pace, and he won't be very happy with himself.
26 seconds from the moment you hit across the yellow line to your exit the lane. It's going to cost him probably 30 seconds or more.
And it's very easy to do. I mean, you're absolutely on the limit. You're trying to get the absolute most of the car going on entry to pit lane and on exit. So you're travelling at 40 kilometres an hour down pit lane, and all you want to do is get off that button. You got your finger on the button. It's easy for that to happen. Music to my ears.
Yeah, exactly. That's why we pause every time that onboard comes on.
Well, here's our Haver and Wood here. This is for our second spot. Two young fellas having a battle.
It's a great drive by Wood. Yep. And Elliot Barber today. Ditto that.
Morgan Haver yesterday finishing third, and then in third again. This is challenging for second. He's in for a very good overall position for the weekend.
And the news just gets worse and worse for Tony Quinn. He's going to get another drive-through penalty for speeding in pit lane while serving his previous penalty. Yes. Goodness me, that's cost him a minute.
I think Tony's been eating too many Darryl Lee chocolates.
Too hyped up. Unbelievable. You've got to calm yourself, this, because you'd be filthy inside the helmet, but you've just got to calm yourself, don't you?
Yeah, easier said than done.
I bet.
Car driver's pretty fiery. That's unfortunate for Tony. It's spoiled his weekend, that has.
Here's take two of the drive-through penalty for car number 7. That's dropped him a minute down the field here. As we enter the final 8.5 minutes, it's down to pit lane with Kylie King.
Chris Mees, obviously the pro driver. You've got your rookie in there in Ryan Millier, but gee, hasn't he done a wonderful job?
Awesome. He's doing an awesome job. I mean, we are leading. We didn't expect that. This track is made for our Audi. We have a weakness of top speed compared to the Ferraris, but right now we are leading, and it's going to be tied with the Lamborghini and the Mercedes, but he's doing a brilliant job.
And how do you rate this series? You travel all around the world. We've got some speedy drivers in this one.
Yeah, the competition is quite high here, but it was definitely worth to come here. It's a good move from the Mercedes right now, so they're chasing us. It was definitely worth it to come here from Europe. It's a long trip, but I really enjoyed it every time again.
Enjoy the watching, and fingers crossed for you guys.
Thank you.
Christopher Mees, thumbs up. He watched his teammate Ryan Millier lead us to the flag here. And change for second while we had that interview going on as Haber. And this is big news for the 47 machine of James Koundouras on the exit of turn number 9.
So he's got some sort of mechanical drama there pulling over, which is extremely rare for that team. They never, ever, ever have mechanical dramas of Michael Newton Automotive does such a great job. They'll be really disappointed, those boys. They work extremely hard.
This is going to be a great battle. D'Alberto all over the back of Graham Smythe. Now he has a look. Is this enough? Yes, it is.
Great move.
Change of position now. So D'Alberto gets up to fourth. He's going to try and get past Richard Gardner here. Smythe goes with him. Gardner gives him racing room.
Yeah, good job there, Gardner. Very aware there of the leaders coming through, or the faster cars coming through.
Oh, now the other Porsche pulls up down there.
It's parked up in sympathy.
Wow. It's a replay of what happened when the two Ferraris swapped positions, and he left it right to the last minute.
Great.
Got it done nicely, yeah. Textbook move.
Right on the limit.
Here's Millier about to put a lap on his teammate here, Steve McLaughlin. Marcus, look at this coming down. It's the battle for the lead. He needs to clear his teammate because the gap is now under a second. Haber is coming up to the back of Ryan Millier.
I think they'll be on the radio. They need to get him to, let him past, and I'm sure he will, and on the front straight. But, you're right. It's dragging Haber up.
Look at this. Gone down 2.5 seconds in the past couple of laps. And Haber gets a sniff of victory here.
Two laps to go, too. He's right there in his, slipstream. And he's flashing him. Morgan's giving him a flash, trying to upset him and psych him out.
McLaughlin is just now going to let him through.
Oh, just there.
What's defensive driving happen here? Who know the blue flags will be hanging out?
I'd like to think of good sportsmanship, but that's the advantage of having a teammate sometimes.
So Haber, what's he got? He took 2.5 seconds down the past, lap and a half here.
Morgan's on the absolute limit there, just using all the road up. Oh. Glenn Wood in the background as well, using all the road. All the boys are pushing with four laps remaining. Time certain here, so it changes things a little bit in this GT racing, but we're all running on time, which is nice.
It's good to see the countdown clock showing 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go. They run down yellow flag, so no passing down this section. They can't clear the 75 JMAC penalty here, so they'll have to wait and hopefully get a run down here at the final turns, or leave it to turn one. Nope, it's going to stick the Mercedes down the inside, and now has clear air. Yeah, and time on his side.
That's given Ryan Millier a bit of a gap there, a bit of breathing space for him to put his head down and keep that gap. Glenn Wood there in second, and in third there now, sorry.
Yeah, that's changed around.
That's a great result. Well, those guys are up into third place. They were punchy yesterday. They qualified fourth. They had good pace, so that sort of matches their car pace for the weekend.
And it just shows, too, that you can actually come back when you've had a tough day yesterday. Yeah, battery failure for the Twig Emery car. These guys had a puncture, and they're still fighting hard inside the top five here.
It's amazing how it works in motor racing. You've got that car pace over a long race. Generally, you'll end up back up in that pace where you qualified fourth, sixth, whatever it is, first. Generally, that's where it ends up, all out in the wash. You end up back in that position.
Oh, Wood's trying to get past the 75 Audi here, and the door shuts.
He really is a bit naughty there. Well, there was a yellow flag
actually,
so good decision not passing him.
He saw it at the last minute and thought, better not do this. We're only 59 seconds from home.
It could spoil your day real quick.
Yeah. So Millier gets 1.8 seconds back to Haber. Approaching the final minute of this race. These guys have done really well. We've said it all race long. Wood and Barber, the number 46 Lamborghini, up to third position, looking down the main straight here as the leader gets past the Adina Apartments entry one more time. The lap car between first and second.
Yeah, that's going to help him as well, putting another car in between him and Morgan. They're both pushing extremely hard here at the end of the race, and all driving very well. The two Ferraris here sort of getting caught up in the traffic here. Tony's having a bit of a peek there up the inside of McLaughlin.
And now they're trying to clear the McLaughlin car.
Yeah, he's going to get a very good tow here. Watch the Ferrari pull up beside him quite easily, I would say.
Over the yellow still out down there. The team has pulled out. He's safe. And now has a clear shot at Ryan Millier, who's got another lap car ahead. Meantime, the 27 Ferrari goes past McLaughlin as well, so he's through.
That's a bit rough. Really should have been let past earlier down the front straight.
Has killed him a bit.
Lap car, but
So clock has stopped. We should get at least one more lap in here. 49 laps into it. Well done. We've gone. Touchwood, safety car free in both races. here this weekend.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And it's made the racing great. I mean, there's nothing worse than a safety car coming out and bringing the whole field back, unless you're down the back and you need it.
Yeah.
Being there before.
Banging the steering wheel now.
Yeah, I need a safety car. Yeah, or the other way. Yeah, a bloody safety car. But yeah,
it's not going to happen today. We're on the final lap. And this guy had to clear Tony DeFelice. What a drive. And in his second run with the J. McPhem Audi team, Ryan Melier. 0.8 of a second it is. He just needs to clear turn six.
Having a big look there in his mirror to see where Morgan Haver is. They're pretty close there. 0.8 The gap's come right back through the traffic. This is classic GT racing, right down to the finish, last lap.
DeFelice could be the man here.
Yep. This could set it up for Morgan here on the inside into the last turn.
Here they come. Nervous moment as another car. There's Rob Smith ahead as well. Drives to the inside. Ooh. And I don't think he's going to do it because there's now two cars in between.
Oh, no.
And through he comes. What a run. The combination of Christopher Meese and Ryan Millier. Fantastic here at Sandown. And they win race two of the Australian GT Championship presented by Pirelli. It was only 1 second at the finish line. Glenn Wood gets home for third position. Great drives then the Lamborghini. Then it was Tony D'Alberto, Graham Smythe, Clark Quinn getting home in for sixth. Then McPherson, Emery, and Tunes, who served a drive-through penalty. And Tony Walls in the next of the McLarens gets a top 10 finish. Great racing over both days. And this guy put an asterisk next to him because he is a star in the making.
Yeah, great job by this. Christopher Meese and Ryan Miller. They were the star of the show today. And great result.
Confirmation on your screen right now. Meese and Millier, the winners here at Sandown, and cement themselves in the championship lead ahead of Haber. Wood was next, then D'Alberto and Daniel Lester, then Quinn, McPherson, Tweed down to Antunes and Walls. Only 40 seconds covering the top 10. And Tony Quinn, two drive-through penalties, saw him finish in 11th position after leading earlier on. Medici was 12th. Back to Voigt, Taylor, McLaughlin, Condouris, down to Hovey and Griffith in 20th, and DeFelice, who had a drive-through penalty also. Indira Patiarchi was 22nd, and some of the hard luck stories further down. And not surprisingly, with that win, puts Meese as your round winner with Ryan Millier this weekend. Just 2 points separating them and D'Alberto and Daniel, who finish on the podium. Well done to Morgan Haber, who gets himself into the top three. It's been a great weekend here in Sandown. Let's hear from our winner.
Well, what a partnership this is proving to be, Ryan. You withstood the pressure in that last race.
Yeah, I just had to keep my eyes forward. Just concentrating on the championship for Chris. So we just kept strong, kept the eyes forward, and just concentrated on my driving to bring it home.
Yeah, that championship. There's not much in it with one round to go, but wow, it's nice to lead.
Yeah, obviously it's always good when you're in the front. You know, it's going to be tight in the end. It will be a nerve-cracking race in Highlands, but I think I have the best co-driver I could get, so I'm quite confident.
Championship-wise, well, they were the round winners this weekend, and Christopher Meese now takes the championship lead with one round remaining, taking that from Nathan Antunes and Grant Denyer, sniffing around for perhaps second spot. And there is the podium. Well done to Christopher Meese and Ryan Millier. Great job, more so to Millier on his second run in the 74 Audi. Well, that's the last round we'll see of them in Australia. They're off to Highlands for the next round of the championship. It's been a great weekend here at Sandown. We'll see you soon.